Hello and welcome to this channel. My name is Victoria and today we're going to talk about systemic lupus erythematosus as part of our pathology series about collagenosis. If you haven't seen the other videos yet, make sure to see those also. Systemic lupus erythematosus is a systemic autoimmune disease which is characterized by the presence of autoantibodies which attack the cells of the patient's own organs. There is not only systemic lupus, but also three other types. The types of lupus are lupus dermatitis, drug-induced lupus, neonatal lupus, and today's topic, systemic lupus erythematosus. The most well-known symptom is the characteristic red butterfly rash over nose and cheeks of the patient's face, but there are more symptoms you should know for your exam. Those are pleuritis and pericarditis, nephritis, poor circulation in fingers and toes, as well as arthritis, muscle aches, ulcers in mouth and nose, and photosensitivity and loss of appetite. So as you can see, systemic lupus involves far more than the skin of the face. Solely the presence of the facial rash is not enough for a precise diagnosis. But what else can be done? Immunohistochemical methods like immunofluorescence can help to prove the presence of increased number of IgM, IgG, and complement protein C3, which is an indicator for systemic lupus. Also, blood screening can be done, in which typically increased erythrocyte sedimentation rate, as well as altered creatinine, urine sedimentation, and increased numbers of antinuclear antibodies, abbreviated ANAs, can be found. The clinical presentation, as well as the blood tests, are gold standard for diagnosing a patient suspected to be affected by this autoimmune disease. But what happens in the body in the development of lupus? There is a systemic loss of self-tolerance, leading to the activation of reactive T and B cells, which in turn lead to the production of antinuclear antibodies and release of cytokines, which ultimately result in destruction of tissues. The exact cause is yet unknown, but it is thought to be linked to environmental and genetic, as well as stochastic events. Treatment of lupus is only symptomatic. Unfortunately, until today, there is no cure. 25% of affected patients present with a rather mild progression, including the characteristic skin rash and hemolytic symptoms. Medications which are frequently used to help patients alleviate their symptoms are NSAIDs, as aspirin or ibuprofen, which relieves pain and decreases inflammatory processes. In mild forms, that might be enough. Other patients also need to take cortisone, especially in exacerbations and severe cases, this is necessary. UV rays can worsen the rash, as well as many patients experience photosensitivity, so UV protection or avoidance might be of help. Individuals may be able to relate the exacerbation of the skin rash to different triggers, like sun, chemicals, wind, stress, or maybe certain foods, so close observation or a rash trigger diary can be also of help for patients. Insufficient treatment or no treatment at all over prolonged time can lead to complications, some of which are fatal. These complications range from skin scarring and joint deformities over stroke, heart attack and avascular necrosis of the hip, to miscarriage and other complications experienced during pregnancy, potentially leading to death of the developing baby. That's all for this video about systemic lupus erythematosus. I hope it was helpful and make sure to subscribe to not miss any of our videos. Thank you very much.